that's real good.
Hi, this is Janet from Manhattan Edit Workshop, and today I'd like to talk about how to import stills into Premiere Pro. First, I want you to note in our preferences, general preferences, there's an option called default scale to frame size. Note that that is currently turned off. So I'm going to bring in this file with default scale to frame size turned off. And let's see what that does. I'm just going to bring in this file here and drop it on the timeline. You can tell by looking in the preview area that not the entire image is showing up in the program monitor. If I look here, this tells me the size of this image, 1680 wide by 1050 tall, but my timeline is 720 by 480. So what I'm seeing in my program monitor is the center part of the photograph. The outer parts are not visible. You'll especially notice it if I shrink this down and click. You'll see the wireframe here is representing the full size of the original still, and what we're currently seeing through the program monitor is what we would output. So as I, this is great because this does allow me to pan around the image while keeping the quality high. Now, for comparison, let's re-import the image, but this time I'm going to change the general setting to turn on default scale to frame size. So I'm checking that, saying okay, and I'm going to re-import it. There we go. So we'll drag our re-imported image, and you'll notice, first of all, that we do see the entire image. If I scale down this time, you can see it's including all of the image in the wireframe, and this is what we would output. I could make this bigger by expanding the wireframe, but this is not the original image, therefore I will be scaling up the rasterized file, and it just may not look good. When I have the default scale to frame size set, Premiere Pro creates a copy of the still that's at the same frame size as your sequence. So what I'm currently working with here is the 720 by 480 and not the original size, which was 1680 by 1050. Now, if I want to change that, I can always right-click on the clip and turn off scale to frame size. Notice the wireframe changes. I'm now looking at the original, so this would be fine to scale up or to do some pan and zoom adjustments. So if you want your imported stills to match the frame size of your sequence, you should make sure that in the preferences general settings, your default scale to frame size is checked. Otherwise, if you want to be able to pan around an image and to be able to adjust the scale of the original file, you want to make sure the default scale to frame size is deselected.